Welcome to Market Movers. I'm Rob Black, and here are the top business money stories of the day.
Today's top story. Let's look at the facts of what's going on in the world. We've had an amazing prosperous run in the United States for 70 years, but in 2008, 2009, we had a hiccup. On a per capita basis, this hiccup was worse. Real personal income per capita, the amount which we take home after adjusting for inflation, is about where it was a decade ago. So what's wrong? Is it regulations and uncertainty? Is it the taxes that's crippling our businesses? Let's put aside politics and just be honest and say no. Our businesses are doing remarkably well. Corporate profits just hit an all-time high. Companies are making more profit per dollar of sales than they ever have before. What's wrong is that the amazing profits at our businesses aren't flowing through to most Americans. They're staying at the top. The percentage of Americans with jobs is the lowest level in three decades. Wages as a percentage of our economy hit an all-time low. There's a lot of reasons for this, some of which is outside of our control, like government. Globalization, for example, it's cheaper to make stuff elsewhere, so companies have shipped jobs offshore. But that's not the only problem. Big debt is a problem. Total debt across our economy has skyrocketed in the last 30 years from very low levels, all things considered, to very high levels. This isn't debt that's just in absolute dollars. Our debt has soared from less than 100% to GDP 30 years ago to more than 350% of GDP. Put differently, the growth of our borrowing has wildly outpaced the growth of our economy. In fact, in the last century, GDP looks like, when you subtract the amount we've borrowed from the amount we've made, it's a big negative number. Anyone can spend when you give them a credit card. So our frantic borrowing over the past 30 years means that our economic growth has been somewhat of a mirage. By the way, when people hear debt, they immediately think of the government. But what I'm talking about here, $50 trillion of debt, it's been accumulated by all of us, not just the government. There are three big groups in our economy: household, corporations, government. Households borrow their way until they had debt coming out their ears. So did corporations, and so did the government, state, local, and federal. Federal government's debt right now, $15 trillion and counting. Put it all together, again, our debt has exploded relative to the size of our economy. We must reverse that. Basically, we got careless and lost our discipline, and there's not going to be any easy way out. So how can you fix the economy? Sit the same way we do anything, right? With sustained discipline, effort, and smart long-term plans. Consumers need to borrow and spend less and save more. The good news is they've already started doing that. Companies need to start sharing more of their revenue with employees. Wages as a percentage of the economy simply have to go up. Yes, this means corporate profit margins will drop, but they can drop a long, long way and still be above average. And this is our country we're talking about. If corporations really are people, it's time for them to start acting like people and sharing some more of their wealth. And then lastly, of course, we have to implement a plan to eventually get our massive government deficit under control. Reasons: we don't want to do this right now as politicians. Basically, in one fell swoop, they'd all be kicked out of office. But we do need a long-term plan.
So those are the top stories that you need to know. Don't forget, tell friends, come back often. I'm Rob Black from Market Movers, and I'll talk to you soon.